In the morning when the sun breaks free, a reflection I know I've seen. In the night it's haunting me, a lonely ghost, a lonely ghost. Ever since I was just a child, I've seen visions in my sleep of a man roaming through the wild with all these ghosts, a lonely ghost. But you can't breathe in if you don't breathe out, 'cause it's a new day, we're gonna go far. Knuckle down, dream and shake off the dead. Well, you know what they say, you can't hide from your ghost. 'Cause it's a new day, I wanna go far. Break it down, jump the gun, find a new way. Well, you know what they say, I'm stuck here living with all these ghosts, a lonely ghost. It's a new day, we're gonna go far. Knuckle down, dream and shake off the dead. Well, you know what they say, you can't hide from your ghost. 'Cause it's a new day, I wanna go far. Break it down, jump the gun, find a new way. You know what they say, I'm stuck here living with all these ghosts, a lonely ghost.
Still got one of your cords?
Yeah, where are you going to put it?
Just right, we're going to right over here, facing the dressing room. Yeah. Facing the
back of the bathroom. You got two going that way?
Yeah.
If John pitches the last cord.
So you don't want none going back towards the dressing room back there?
Huh?
My name is Alan Wallace. We are here at the Rialto Theater tonight in Marlton, Arkansas. I am founder of Off the Chain Paranormal. This is a theater that we've been to many times. This is one of our favorite places to come to for a paranormal investigation. I'd like to go ahead and let my group introduce themselves, starting at the end down here with John, and just kind of come around.
My name is John Sparks, Off the Chain Paranormal.
My name is Lucinda Long with Off the Chain Paranormal.
I'm Casey Myers, and I'm a Rialto player.
I'm Janine Wallace, and I am co-founder of Off the Chain Paranormal.
Chase Hayden, I'm a newer team member of Off the Chain Paranormal.
I'm Kim Hayden, a newer member of Off the Chain Paranormal.
We originally came to the Rialto Theater in 2012, and we were finally able to come here and do a paranormal investigation, and we've had many experiences since we've been here. You know, when we come, we set up a DVR system and a monitor, and we run cameras throughout the theater and to try to capture different things. We have quite a bit of equipment that we use. But as far as experiences here at the Rialto, we've had several. We've had things that we just could not debunk. We've had things that we just, you know, make us scratch our head. We've heard voices many times, places that there absolutely was no one there. We've heard knocking. We've heard all kinds of different sounds. One time in particular, my own personal experience, I was doing an investigation here about a year ago, and I had all of my team members up in the balcony, and I had an amplifier down here on the stage, and I was talking through the amplifier, trying to see if we could provoke some sort of activity. And the building was locked up. All my team members were in the balcony. But I had a little problem with the amplifier, so I came down to the stage here to adjust the amplifier. I was the only one down here. Everyone else was in the balcony. The building was locked. Everyone was accounted for. And when I arrived on stage here to work with the amplifier, a cold chill wind just like go through me. And as I looked over here to this side of the stage, the curtain was back at the time, I could see a shadow walking down the hallway and hear the footsteps. And there was absolutely nobody or nothing back there. And that was one of my top experiences here, apart from some of the stuff that we've captured on film and video.
What I'm doing right now is kind of trying to get a base reading on what the temperature is. It seems up in the balcony it's about, in the balcony it's 86 degrees, whereas down here, base temperature is about 76 degrees on average. And basically, what I'm going to do is take a base temperature, that way if we do happen to hit any kind of pockets of cold air, any odd feelings, or like in previous investigations, we've actually had rooms that had no air circulation and a mist would form. And the temperature was notably lower.
Okay, basically, how this works is the laser I'm using is just a guide. There's actually a sensor that it puts out, and whatever the laser is pointing to, it bounces off that object, kind of like radar or sonar, and then it comes back and gives me a fairly accurate temperature within maybe 0.1 or 0.2. That's about the area of, but basically, just give me a base temperature, and I can point anything I can. Most things like this. Now, sometimes with darker colors, I can't get a good reading, but walls, floors, also any kind of piping work, any duct work, wiring, things like that, we can get a temperature on and see if there's any kind of difference in there, or if, again, if there's any cold spots. Sometimes there are people at work that wear something, an apparition, made its presence known, or where something was walking that the floor actually felt cold. You can tell the difference.
So up here, most of the temperature on average is about 76 degrees, and the back it's about 71 degrees. So if we have any fluctuations of it getting any lower than that, then probably more than 5 degrees, we can kind of start looking for if perhaps it's the air or if there's a draft anywhere or anything like that. But with it being so hot outside, it shouldn't be getting any cooler.
The first time that we came here, when we got here and we was doing our walkthrough, and we got behind this stage area, and the very first thing, it felt like somebody had just run their hand right up my arm. And then we went on with our walkthrough, and then we started our investigation, and we did some EVPs and things, and we did we stayed in the dressing room behind here, the first dressing room, and we had quite a bit of activity in it, and then we got quite a bit of activity up in the balcony area. And when we went home, it was like the following Monday, and it was early in the morning, and my husband was getting ready to go to work, and I felt something like a hand, like fingers, just in the small of my back, twisting. And this kind of went on for several nights. Things happened to me. And it took me quite some time to get rid of this attachment, but I did eventually get rid of it. And so this is my first time back here.
What I got here right here is a Obvious 4. What it's doing, you can see, it's got a bars up here. It picks up the energy around the Obvious. When spirits conduct energy, what it does is it computes through the system. System cannot be messed with, cannot be altered in any way. It's got a
party.
And it likes to party. It has a story, or has a memory of about over 3,000 words. And whatever power it generates is what word comes out. The last investigation, when we played our music on the computer, what we're probably going to do here in a little bit, what did it say? It said, music reel.
Yeah.
We asked if we want to play music, and it stated music reel. It at times, it has worked very well on telling us certain key words to questions that we asked. It doesn't generally say it right off the bat, but over time, it usually states an answer to our question, just like it said, Edna. I asked about probably 10 minutes ago. Is there anybody in here? Can you give us a name of the person that is in here? And it gave me Edna. So that's Obvious. It's been very handy. It's got a lot of
sense.
Party talk. just like that. It's random. I mean, we're not pressing any buttons of any sort. This right here is the same thing. It picks up voices. If like I'm talking right now, it's picking up my talking as it's going along. You were quiet, and it's picking up very light, which is probably picking up the air conditioner and other noises around. This right here is a radius. It does a sweep around the entire, like, I don't know how far it reads, but it reads in a 3-foot radius around you. And it's basically the same as the one that goes in front. And it changes the color around it also. See, everybody's sitting still, so it's staying the same color. We like to use this one. It usually picks up quite a few words that we can actually use it to help talk.
Fury, Kate, Pond.
Fury, Kate, and Pond. We got another name.
Kate, K-A-T.
Mm-hmm. Was Katie furious? Pond, like a pond, P-O-N-D.
Yes, the first show that I was in here at the Rialto, of course I grew up coming to the Rialto when it was a movie theater, so I love this place. And I was backstage in the back portion where you were talking about you being, and I was reading my script. I was the only one back there. There were actors on stage. There was a mic stand that had a guitar hook to it. I was reading my script and I saw something move, and I looked and the arm of it came up and then it went down very slowly. I kind of went, no, that just didn't happen. Went back to reading my book, and the handle came up and down quickly and then went up again and came down slowly again. At that point, I started listening to see if there was a train out front, because we're right on the railroad tracks. They're right across the street from us. There wasn't a train. I tried to see if there was an earthquake that would cause it. I even reached over to see if it would move, and it was very hard to move. At that time, one of the actors came off stage, and I guess I was just kind of in shock. And I told her what happened, and she said, oh yeah, that's the ghost. And I had no idea that there was any type of activity here. Another time, well, a lot of times I do costuming for the shows, and I was up in the balcony area. That's where we keep our costume room, is where the projector used to be. And there is just a presence there that just feels like it's bearing down on you, like someone just right there staring at you, or just about to touch you. It's just a harsh, it just feels harsh. I've never had anything happen to me up there except just that feeling. It's very foreboding and scary. Don't like to be up there by myself. Sometimes it's really hot in that room, and sometimes it's very cold. I don't think I've ever had a comfortable temperature up there as far as being in that room. Of course, it's in the very top of the theater. And of course, some of the times I've been here with them, we've had voices that have spoken. I remember the one time my son was here, and he was holding a listening device and heard a little girl say no. And he just nearly threw it and ran out of the ran out of the theater. He said that was one of the scariest experiences he had ever had. But that's just a few of the things. In the women's dressing room, we used to have a doll. I don't know who brought it. I think it may have been somebody from your group that brought this doll, because they felt like there was a female child that was here in the building, and the doll has disappeared. I don't know, the last time I was here, which was about a year ago, the doll had disappeared and it hasn't reappeared. I've asked several people if they've seen it, and they haven't. So we don't know where the doll disappeared to. And at one point we even put the doll up in the room when it was here and left the room and came back, and it had moved. It hadn't fallen, it had actually moved to a different, at least a foot or two from where it was sitting for no reason. So that's some of what's happened here at the Rialto.
He was a boogie boogie bugle boy of Company B. And when he
okay. We will get John in here with the Obulus now, the rest of the team, and we will set up and see if we can do some music instigation here paranormally. And this is a Bluetooth wireless jambox speaker. What we're going to be doing tonight is, I've got some stuff here on the laptop downloaded, a lot of music from different areas of America's past. We're going to be going through these different areas of music to see if we can get a response on the Obulus. Now, Casey, you grew up around here, so John Wayne's been shown on this screen. Yes. Clint Eastwood.
Yes.
Abbott and Costello.
I assume so.
Yeah, I'm sure that was before your time. I know that. So that's, you know, but pretty much all of that. And lots of country music, Patsy Cline and stuff like that, yeah, has been here. So we've got pretty much all that. So we're gonna see if we can trigger that. So we're gonna set this pretty much here in the middle. And I'm not gonna play the entire music song. I'm gonna play just maybe a third of it, see if we can trigger something. And it's going to be a little bit loud, so we probably won't hear the Obulus actually speak, but it will come up on the screen.
Pick it up on that.
that one was from the 1940s. That was very famous in the Abbott Costello movies. So far, we haven't picked up anything yet on that one. Let's try the King. Let's see what we get. Or if you were here when this type of music was here, if you could show us a sign that you're here or your presence of any kind, if you could speak through this device on the stage, we would appreciate it very, very much. I'll play just another couple minutes or a couple of seconds of this. Let us know if you like this or not, or I'll go to something else. Everybody, let's roll. Everybody knows. Like something else? All right, let's try this. Maybe you like country a little bit. Maybe you like the Man in Black.
Love is a burning thing, and it makes a fiery ring, bound by wild desire. I fell into a ring of fire. I fell into a burning ring of fire. I went down, 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 and the flames.
If you like something particular, go ahead and say something. Any genre, just tell us. We'll play it for you. We have all kinds of genre. Or if you want us to stop playing it, tell us.
If you could speak to this device for us, we sure would appreciate it. We're gonna play some more to see what you like. See if you like this one.
Alan, do you have any Alice Cooper?
Alice Cooper. I've got.
You can. Said that,
you can patch into.
Kathy would clean here. She would play Alice Cooper, and that was when she would hear the boots on the stage or the sound above
okay.
the stage.
Well, I mean, that would explain a lot because we played Metallica.
Ozzy.
It was Ozzy.
Get his chairs out of the way.
When I had my digital recorder back in the women's dress room, and we heard a lot of noises from the feedback from the Aussie.
Any particular Alice
yeah,
Cooper?
Yeah,
just she played just all of his music.
Okay.
Trillion.
What is that?
Trillion. Reed. Trillion and Reed.
Reed like R E.
Or EAD.
Jesus.
sentence.
You ain't living in a video. You're flying over where the high velocity.
What did it say?
Sentence. Yeah.
Sentence.
Like a sentence in a word sentence. Or a prison sentence. Stupid. Talk. Dump the track.
I go walking after midnight out in the moonlight, just like we used to do. I'm always walking.
Tell us if you want to change it.
After midnight, searching for you. I walk for miles along the highway. Well, that's just my way.
You want to listen to more? More oldies and country? And, or do you want to listen to metal, rock? Please say metal and rock.
Okay. Let's jump the track a little bit more. We're going to come back to music. Let's do this. We know at one time or another, Clint Eastwood was up on this screen, thank the Lord, one of the greatest actors of our time. And some of my favorite westerns that he made was the Man with No Name trilogy. So. Were you here when Clint Eastwood was on this screen? Did you like that?
No, sorry.
Did you like that? Of the three that he made, this is my personal favorite that I enjoyed the most. I liked all of them, but for a few dollars more.
Wire.
Just said wire. Did you like that one?
W-I-R-E. Air.
was Alice Cooper there?
Yeah, that was the Rocks.
Okay. He was showing me that when we were playing Alice Cooper, he captured a blue orb back behind John here on the stage. And we hit Alice, so we're going to try Alice one more time.
It's a chili orb. Preacher Guts. Preacher got what? Skills? Preacher. I think a preacher, church preacher. And got. G-O-T.
They're telling you need a preacher. Well, maybe preacher. You should try some
preacher.
Awesome. Preacher. And got?
Got.
So maybe they're asking
you. G-O-T. Oh, geez.
Writing well.
I can tell you, she's a writer. Sentence, writing, okay. Well. She can write good sentences.
Okay. We got some more orbs from Alice back here on the stage.
Bars when you started playing that than anything else.
Less?
Yeah, I ain't got barely two. W-E-N-T and heard, H-E-A-R-D. You got an Alice Cooper fan.
Went and heard.
Guess it went to it. Heard him. Or heard him here. Higher over here.
Jumped.
Like jump. And you jump. Jumped. J-U-M-P-E-D. Jumped.
It'd be one span tail.
I was just thinking it.
Yeah.
Try this one.
It's actually going down to one.
I tell you what we'll do. We'll take a break from the music for a little bit. And sometimes by taking a break and coming back, one thing we can do after this, we'll take a little break.
I can tell you, it's something over there.
Something over there?
Because I don't get nothing. I'm too barred right here. But when I walk over there, I end up getting 3, 4, just in those corners.
Now, is that where the amp is?
Well, it's back there. This is halfway.
We'll take a break for a little bit, and then we'll go in the dressing room, try some stuff, like we did with take the obvious in the dressing room, see if we can get Chris to roll around. Then we'll hit the stairs, the wardrobe room, do a little bit more music, and see what, cash in on that.
My first experience with the Rialto was the last investigation that we done here, which was last year. It was my very first investigation with Off Chain Paranormal. I ran into an entity, and his name was Chris. Chris contacted me pretty much the whole night that we were here, probably off and on for a good 4 hours. Every investigation that we have been on since then, Chris is usually with me. He doesn't seem to come home with me. It just seems to be connected to this group and what we do. But when we do investigations that are close to this location, when I seem to drive back home, I kind of, in the middle of the night, am tired and will lose my way. And somehow, I don't know how, but I always end up in front of this theater. I don't know what the significance to that is. I do believe it may be Chris, or it may be a connection that I have with this place. I don't know. I just know that it's very unsettling sometimes, but he does not mean any harm. He did help me the last time that I was here, but that was my very first experience here, and I have a very deep connection with this place probably because of that.
The only other instance I had was back in the women's dressing room, also was where a lot of it stems from. Sitting there by myself, nobody was in the room. Been sitting there for about 15 minutes, and just got a cold presence in front of me. I was sitting just like this, and started getting chill bumps all over my arms, and then just felt like somebody was standing right in front of me. Didn't really feel harmful or anything of that nature. Just it was there. They wanted to let me know that it was there. Didn't shock me of any sort, just kind of surprised me that it was actually cool. It was the first time I actually felt a really chill over my entire body. And then after that, it went away. And then after we got the investigation over with, the following day, I was listening to my evidence, and I left the digital recorder in that room all night. And two instances, which there was no little girl in our group at all, and twice, I heard a little girl giggling. Both times.
It's cooler. I don't know if it's just because it was hot.
I don't know if it's because we was up there or what, but my eardrum felt like it was going to explode.
Hello. Oh, chair. Watch out for the chair.
The last time we were here over a year ago, we had a, we had a woman here by the name of Miss Bowen that came with us. And she was a skeptic. And we had not had, we were using the SP7 Spirit Box that night. We hadn't really had a lot of success with it. And we came in here that night. Well, you put it in our promo video. That's when we were doing this.
Yeah.
Yeah. Turn on the flashlight. It was in this room that was taken. And she just was blown completely away. I mean, when I counted to three, you could actually hear it on the SP7 count.
That was in the other room, wasn't it?
Was it, I think, was it the other one?
Was I here? It was in the other room.
It was the other
room?
It
wasn't in here, yeah.
Okay. Yeah. We'll turn these flashlights on again, see what happens. But this time we've got the ovulus.
The first time that we did our investigation here, the very first time, mm-hmm. this is the room where we got the most activity. Mm-hmm. And
me and some of the other girls, I stayed in here for a very long time, and we made contact with a female. Actually, this is the room where we believe that I picked up my attachment because we had that ball in here.
Yeah.
And I was sitting, actually, in this chair, and it was over there, and I was touching the ball. I would put my hand on it, and then I would ask questions, and it would answer me very quickly. And that's where I believe that I got my attachment.
Don't try to give it.
No. It's already coming on.
Can you turn that off? Can you turn that off for us?
You just take your hand off of there because you might be trying.
Can you turn that off?
Ask you some questions. Not yet. Turn the flashlight off.
Watch this too. The flashlight came on, but this didn't hit, but that doesn't mean anything. So we'll see if we can correlate this with the flashlight coming on. Go ahead and get ready.
Is there anyone here with us? Turn the flashlight on. Is there a female here with us? Someone drowned you? Okay, you can turn it off now. Are there others here with you? If there are other spirits here with you, can you turn that flashlight on?
October. Flowers.
October, that's what it said.
Did she die in October?
Did you get flowers?
Did you die in October?
Did you die in October? If you did, turn the flashlight on. Are you saying October because that's when my birthday is? if you are, turn that flashlight on for me. If that's what you're talking about. Very good, thank you.
Give. Vern.
What? Give what?
Give. Vern. What about give?
Can you speak into that device that he's holding?
Position. Soldier.
Position. Soldier. Can you say a name of a person that's in this room?
If Chris is here, light up all three of those flashlights.
Chris, is that you? Light up another flashlight. Light up another one. Hurry.
Good job. Turn them back off.
Getting anything?
Can you turn them back off, please? Chris, is that you? Have you been following us around?
Is it frozen?
No, doesn't seem to be.
You have. Good job. Did you ride down here with us? No. Was you already here when I got here?
Edna. Help.
Edna, there's that name again. Edna, second time.
Edna, do you know Vern?
I had one said Vern. Vern.
Was it Vern?
Do you know a man named Vern that comes around here?
Well, it sounds like a couple of Vern and Edna.
That is.
False one.
Okay, you can turn it off now. Whoa.
Can you turn that off?
That one on the wall.
Can you turn that off?
Thank you.
Edna, have you been following us around all night? If you have, turn that flashlight off.
I think Edna's been having too much following.
First investigation is official team members. Wally here talked about the different equipment we bring and so forth. One of the pieces of equipment we bring is an obelisk. And basically what it is, it's a machine designed to pick up energy. If there's something out there trying to contact us, and the energy goes into this box, which can't be altered in any way. All you can do is put batteries in it, turn it on and off. There's nothing you can do to it. You can't program it with a computer, you can't control it remotely, you can't do anything like that. And it has a dictionary in it with several thousand words. So basically what this does is pick up energy, and if something's trying to communicate or talk to us, it puts it in the form of words. Well, she had gone to the basement area of where we were investigating, and she said she heard a noise. So I went down there to check it out with her, and the rest of the team members were sitting up because we were in another theater much like this, and they were by the stage. As soon as I walked down there, they said that the obelisk went off, and the three words on it were wife, lust, and daddy. And next day, my wife turned up positive for pregnant, and as of last Tuesday, we saw a picture of our baby and its little heartbeat.
Could be a big coincidence.
It could be, but at the same time, even if it could have been tampered with or anything like that, there's nobody here that would, because it was just this group, there's nobody that would have known. And we didn't even know. But it was certainly something that sent chills up my spine when I found out.
So we'd been hoping for that for quite some time, but we hadn't really spoken to any of them about it. You know, so those three words by themselves might not say anything, but just the fact that they interpreted it that way immediately, and then the very next day, kind of gave me pause at least.
We'll see if it's not going to probably happen, but
when Jason comes back up, kind of watch that hallway back there and see if you see any kind of shadow movement. Because like the last time we all did the balcony thing, like I said, went down to the stage, everybody was here, then there was something walking down that hallway. And you hear the footsteps, see the shadow. And that was awesome. Always think, like to see something black that shadow out, or black that light out, across that light field up here. That'd be awesome. Can you turn one of those flashlights on for us? I don't care which one. Can you turn one of those flashlights on for us? We're up here in the balcony. Is Chris here tonight? When I count to three, can you see if you can turn one of those flashlights on for us? Yeah. I know it takes a lot of energy to do that. When I count to three, I don't care which one you turn on. Can you try to turn one on for us? Very good. Very good. I got a 0.01 on the EMF.
What?
Yeah, he got a hit on the EMF when he did that.
That was because
can you turn
moved.
That off for us, please? Can you please turn it off? Thank you.
Good job.
Now this sounds stupid. Can we do it one more time when I count to three? I'm going to count to three and see if you can turn that on for us. One. Use off. Hang on. Please hang on. Hang on. Not yet. When I count to three, use all your energy that you can. One, two, three.
Oh, that's perfect.
Good job.
Thank you.
Having trouble with that.
That was pretty good. That was on the count of three. Are we all agreed?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh.
That's good.
Well, three and a half, but yeah.
Yeah. Can you turn that off for us? That was awesome. Completely awesome. That was great. Thank you. Thank you. If you're the little girl that stays up here, can you turn that flashlight on, please? Are you the little girl who stays up here? If you can turn two of those flashlights on at the same time, if you're the little girl, can you do that? Or just turn on one?
Ooh.
That was okay.
Spot on. That one, the other ones were the ones that were doing it.
That, you did turn on two flashlights, yes you did. Can you turn that one off, please? Can you turn it off? Can you turn that off for us, please? Thank you.
How many others are here with you? One. Two. Three. Four. Are there more than four? Very good.
Do you have any friends up here? Good.
Do you hide in this balcony because you're afraid?
Obviously still working.
Witch.
Okay,
witch.
I guess that's a yes.
Witch?
Witch and then wish.
There's an evil witch that's up here.
Witch? Is there a witch up here?
Good job. Is there a woman up here on this balcony that likes to scare people? Is she pretty evil?
Cool. God.
That's what I thought. Bright. Is it the same woman that was up here with me the last time that I was here? Can you turn it back off, please? Good job. Is the evil witch lady up here with us right now? Good job. Thank you.
Do you hang out in this dressing room behind us?
Good job. Thank you. Can you speak into that device that Kim's holding in her hands and tell us how old you are?
You can turn the flashlight off now. Thank you.
Can you speak into the ovulus box for us?
Is the witch lady mean to you? Does she not like us being here?
Is there someone in the dressing room back here behind us? I'm going to take the ovulus, go into the dressing room, open that window, see what happens.
Radio. What you feel?
Nine. Religion.
Probably 9 years old. Are you 9 years old?
Okay, I'm in this dressing room up here.
Stuff.
Stuff.
Yeah, there's stuff in there.
Casey says she doesn't like to be in here. She feels uncomfortable up here. Is there something in this room? What religion? What about nine?
I think she's nine, Molly, because I just said I think that's how old she is.
Is the little girl nine? Is there anything in this room? Little girl, are you nine? Are you 9 years old? Little girl, if you're here, can you say something through the ovulus? This machine I'm holding, can you say something? Even if I'm not the little girl, if you're the witch or whatever, can you say something through this box? Now, you can turn flashlights on all day. Can you speak through the box? We had a good investigation tonight, I think. We tried some new stuff, with the music, different things. We went into a few little small areas that we hadn't been in before.
you know, and as you go along in paranormal investigation, some nights are off the chain, and some nights are, you know, a little smoother. This was a good night. A good investigation is good. We didn't have a lot, you know, of activity, but we had activity here and there intermittent. So that was my thought on it. So who else likes it?
I think we did pretty good. We tried some new things, like Alan said, with the music. We're getting the hang of that and learning how to match that up with the ovulus and get a better response with it and see, communicate with them a little bit more to see what they like. So far, it's been heavy metal, but which I didn't see that coming. But I think that has a lot to do with the people that have worked here, and they've gotten used to that presence and that kind of music. But as far as everything else goes, I think we've done pretty well.
Yeah, we had a great time. We got some pretty quick responses with the flashlights, and to see those work together with the obelisk at the same time, or the music with the obelisk. It's really neat to see everything kind of work together and play off of each other. So it was a great time.
We came across two pretty dominant presences tonight, which was the little girl, which we do not know her name, and a female named Edna. So far, we have found out that Edna is below the age of 30, and she does have children that are here with her. So I don't know if the little girl, maybe in correlation with that, is her daughter. I couldn't get that much out of her. But I do know that she's under the age of 30. She does not stay here all the time. She comes and goes as she pleases. And she did enjoy the fact that we were here. She liked speaking with us, and she has been following us around all night long. So she seemed to be the pretty dominant entity that we've got for this evening on this investigation.
I think we was kind of surprised about the witch, but then you don't never know what you're going to get.
You never know.
You know, it said witch and wish at the same time, yeah. So maybe it misspoke.
And of all the music,
wishes is a witch.
Yeah.
You know, of all the music that was played, Alice Cooper was the one that it hit more on.
See, that's for some reason, I don't know why it's, everything's tied into it. Usually ends up being, especially here, has been metal or Aussie or.
Mm. It's a more aggressive.
Well, Kathy played that. That one, still, Casey said that Kathy would come in and play that. That could be that reason.
Mr. Chase?
Basically, I'm looking forward to reviewing the evidence, because I found that in our investigations, even on nights where it might be a little slower than what we'd like, we find some really interesting things once we go back and look at all the pictures and video evidence and so forth. Overall, I think it was a good night, but I mostly always just look forward to the review. You know, we've been surprised several times by things that we hadn't caught until we sat down and looked at everything. Because as we find, when you look at all the little details, that's where you find the best stuff.
Yeah. I feel the man on the stage. I feel it's a male. The little girl came to me in a dream.
Yeah.
And in this dream, she was showing me things. And she did show me that there was a male on the stage area.
She
hangs out in the balcony because she doesn't really care much for the male that hangs on the stage. And that's how that connected.
Yeah, we Off the Chain Paranormal, Arise Productions, and Blind Man Bluff Productions, we're going to be working together on some projects coming up.
Yeah.
And we've had a busy year, and it's going to be continuing like that. And, going to new places we've never been.
That was a big one.
Trying new investigations we've never done. So stay tuned.
Boom.